This is All India Radio, Shillong, the Northeast News Bulletin, read by Miranda Blah. The Assam government is setting up 3 COVID care centres in and around Guwahati with 1,405 beds. Health Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma said that the COVID centres would come up soon as necessary steps have already been taken. He said that 255 beds COVID care centre at Kuhikuchi, 400 beds at Sarusajai and 750 beds temporary hospital including 200 beds ICU at Kanapara are coming up. Assam has recorded 2,384 new COVID positive cases and 12 deaths yesterday. Kamrup Metro District reported 883 cases, the highest for any district. Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal has clarified that the state government was not in favour of declaring lockdown and urged all to follow the COVID protocols strictly. On the other hand, nearly 60,000 persons have been vaccinated during the last 24 hours. In Meghalaya, all open market traders dealing in essential commodities have been directed to display the price cum stock board at a prominent place in their shops for the general information of the consumers. This was directed by Deputy Commissioner Supply East Khasi Hills District yesterday following reports of rise in price of various items in open markets in the wake of the decision to close down all non-essential shops in Shillong for 1 week, that is from the 26th of this month to 2nd of May due to the surge of COVID-19 cases in the state capital. Yesterday, 146 new COVID-19 positive cases were reported, taking the total number of active cases to 1,238, while 38 persons have recovered, taking the number to 14,236. The centre will provide free food grains to poor people for 2 months in May and June under the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Adna Yojana. Under this scheme, 5 kilograms per person per month of food grains will be provided each month. The government will provide the food grains to nearly 80 crore beneficiaries covered under the National Food Security Act, NFSA. The Consumer Affairs Ministry said that NFSA beneficiaries belonging to both Antyodaya Anna Yojana and priority households will get the allocation over and above their regular monthly NFSA entitlement. The government will spend more than 26,000 crore on this initiative. Assam Downtown University and Dr. B. Bora Cancer Institute, Guwahati, have signed a memorandum of understanding for academic and research collaboration. Representatives from both the institutes also discussed the areas of synergies which can be facilitated under the purview of the collaboration. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will share his thoughts with the people in the country and abroad in the Mann Ki Baat program on All India Radio tomorrow. It will be the 76th episode of the monthly radio program, which will be broadcast on the entire network of AIR and Doordarshan and also on AIR News website www.newsonair.com and News on AIR mobile app. It will also be streamed live on the YouTube channels of AIR, DD News, PMO and Information and Broadcasting Ministry. AIR will broadcast the program in regional languages immediately after the Hindi broadcast. The regional language versions will be repeated at 8 in the evening. Manipur paid rich tributes to Kongjom war heroes who valiantly fought against the British in the Anglo-Manipuri War in 1891. The program was held at Kongjom War Memorial Complex, Thobal District. Kongjom Day was observed every year on the 23rd of April to remember the brave sons of Manipur who made supreme sacrifice for the cause of their motherland. Chief Minister N. Biren Singh and other dignitaries, including Deputy Chief Minister Y. Joykumar, ministers, MPs, MLAs, officers, paid floral tributes at the Kongjom War Memorial and the statue of Puna Braja Bashi. Mr. Biren Singh called upon the people of the state to follow the footsteps of the forefathers with a sense of nationalism and maintain unity among different communities for bringing overall development in the state. And with that, we end the Northeast News Bulletin, which came to you from the Shillong Station of All India Radio. Have a nice day.